Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I'm going to show you how you could find your iPhone again. Chances are if you're tuning in today, you don't have your iPhone. I'm going to show you two different techniques that you could use to find your iPhone again. All right, well, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go lose my iPhone and then we're going to go find it. So I have a 17-month-old boy at home and you would be surprised at the number of places he hides things. So we have this box of 200 blocks. And what he could very well do is he could take my phone and he might bury it in the 200-piece mega blocks, and I would probably never find it again. So why don't we go hide the phone in here and then I'll forget where it is, and then we'll go find it and see if we could get it back. All right, here we go. Here goes the iPhone. Yeah, I would never find that. All right, well, I have completely forgotten where my phone went. My son hid it somewhere in the house. How am I gonna find it again? Well, hey, luckily, it's really easy to find your phone again. All you need to be able to do is you either need a Mac or a PC, and we're gonna go to iCloud.com. So let's jump in and go ahead and do it. Here I am on my desktop, and I'm gonna open up the Chrome browser, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna type in iCloud.com. And once we're on iCloud, you're gonna be prompted to sign in with your Apple ID. Hopefully you remember your Apple ID. I have mine right here, and I also have the password associated with it saved in Chrome. And I'm gonna go ahead and sign in now. So let's go ahead and sign in. And once I'm on the main iCloud homepage, you'll see all my different apps here. One of them is called Find iPhone. What we're gonna do is we're gonna click on this. So I'm gonna click on Find iPhone. And what it's doing now is it's locating the phone. So here you can see a map of where I live. Hopefully none of you come visit me at home. If you do, hopefully you bring a present. And so here it is. What I could do is I'll click on all devices and you'll see that right now I just have one Apple device set up here. It's my iPhone. And right now it's locating that device. So it looks like it's finding that device. It knows the last location that it was in. And I could do a few different things. I could have it play a sound, which will help me find where the phone is, especially if it's in the house or if it's somewhere where you know it is, the sound will help you get back to it. And there's another option where you could turn on lost mode, and I'll show you what that does in a moment. And then you could also just erase the iPhone. If you're pretty sure that there's no way you're gonna get it back, let's say it's been a week since you lost it, you could just erase it, and that way no one could access any of the data on there. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna play a sound, and let's see what happens. Okay, and there's the sound. So first it starts out with a vibration, then it starts with a ringing sound, and so that way you can find your way back to the phone. What we're gonna do next is we're gonna turn the phone into lost mode. This way, if you left it somewhere where you're not gonna be able to hear the ringing sound, perhaps someone will find the phone and they'll be able to get it back to you. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on lost mode. What I can do is I'll enter a phone number. So let's just say I entered my phone number here. Then I'm gonna click on next, and what I can do is I can enter a message that will be shown on your phone or on your iPhone. So here are the default messages: this iPhone has been lost, please call me. And so this message will show up on the screen. I'll show you what that looks like. And then once you click on done, the phone will be locked. So you won't be able to unlock it unless you enter the passcode in. And then other things like your let's say your Apple ID, when you get back on the device, you're gonna have to re-enter that to be able to use the device again. So let's go ahead and click done, and then we'll see what happens. And then the last one is erase iPhone, and that's not something I wanna do. I don't wanna erase my iPhone, but you can imagine what that does. So those are three steps to be able to find your iPhone again. And what I'm gonna do next now is I'm gonna show you a second method to find your iPhone. This method works if you have Google Maps on your phone. What Google Maps does is it'll keep track of your location. So I'm gonna go onto Google Maps and just show you how that works. So we'll go to Google Maps. And what I'll do is within the, so if you click on the hamburger menu on the left-hand side, top left-hand corner, there is something that is called your timeline. I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. The timeline thing is really cool. What that does is it tracks your location over time where you've been. Here I can see all the trips that I've done since I got my iPhone. So, you know, here are some trips in Europe. I've also been to Hawaii, to Bermuda, a few different places. So it's a cool way to keep track of where you've been. But what I could do now is I could say, hey, where am I today? And today what it shows is, so it's July 14th. It'll show my current location. And so with this then, what I could do, so let's expand this. Here I could see kind of the final position of where I was today. And so that shows me my home location on here. So using Google Maps as well, you can track back where your phone is. Unfortunately, it won't tell you if you've lost it somewhere in your house or if you've lost it in the park. It won't tell you the specific spot where it is. It'll give you kind of the general location, but that tends to be good enough. And if you left it somewhere, it'll probably remind you of where it might be. So those are two different methods to find your iPhone again. Hopefully they were both helpful. If you have a son at home who tends to hide things, I found this to be extremely useful to be able to find my phone again. You know, he'll put it in different drawers. He'll put it in different locations under a pillow. It's hard to know where it is, but I get it back using these methods. If you found your iPhone again, please give it a thumbs up. If you're still looking for the iPhone, but you think you might find it again, please also give it a thumbs up. And even if you didn't find it, but this was still helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see future content like this, please hit that subscribe button. That way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. And if there are other topics that you'd like to see me cover, leave a comment down below and I'll add it to my list of future videos to do. All right, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for tuning in. Hope you found your phone. See you next time. Bye.